think I can speak for all of us who have witnessed this phenomenon called Alan Pace. He's a force of nature. And I think all of us understand that we would not be here today. Yesterday morning, as the nation began to commemorate 9/11, John Schnurr is sitting here, and as you know, founded New Leaders for New Schools. Told a story to a group that he'd never told before in public, and it was about his wife. Then on 9/11, she was at a meeting in the World Trade Center tower. And as it happened, her meeting was on the 34th floor. And she was able to escape safely. And today they have two wonderful children, aged 3 and 1. And John went on to point out that as he thought about where we are right today, that there were so many people who happened to be on the 9th floor or above who perished, who had no chance to escape. And there were people on the 70th floor, some escaped, some did not. But he said, you know, isn't that very parallel to the way life is in the country today and in so much of the world. If you're born in the right zip code, if you happen to have a chance to be born in the right area, you'll probably succeed in life. If you're born in the wrong zip code, you have almost no chance. If you're born somewhere in between, maybe, maybe not. But there's a certain randomness about that. And it really does deny the whole notion that we talked about last night, the promise of the Declaration, that all men are created, all women are created, all men all should have an equal chance at the starting line. And yet they do not. And is that understanding in the sense that as the world is changing so rapidly with globalization and technology, there are people who are breaking through, who are born in the right zip code, who were on the 34th floor. And there are so many others who are being left behind. And this brings us to a crucial moment. A moment that, in some ways, is both, it's a double-edged sword. It's a moment that has, it confronts us with some of the most serious problems we have faced as people for a long, long time. Problems that are urgent, that need to be addressed quickly, that will overwhelm us unless we act quickly. And yet, at the same time, we have a coming together of confluence of events at this moment that are very positive, that are really very hopeful and encouraging. We have universities and foundations and benefactors who speak here, speak elsewhere, and are willing to step up and say, let's change, let's be engaged, let's be engaged in the service of government. We have, for the first time in living memory, two candidates who have come together last night. And both of them can come up and saw a convention in front of all of us, in front of a large fellowship. That they are both points forward. If we were had this, this was an important moment for all of us. We have the foundations in place to build it. Foundations built by people like John Grisham, the L.C., the Parish Walker, and so many others, who have put together national organizations and commitments as part of our national effort. But the most important, by far and away the most important part of this magic moment, is the fact that there's a rising generation some here in this room and so many of us who deeply care about change, about social change, about social justice. And you have given this country countless dollars, countless efforts. You're a social entrepreneurs who found new ways to tackle a social issue. Many of you have been out and volunteered. But the single most important reason why there's a chance now of seizing upon this moment is the rising generation. This is the most important movement, I must tell you, and most encouraging movement I've seen among the young since the days of the civil rights movement. And I really see you as a pioneer. So it's in that sense that we gather to act now, okay? We're at this moment. How do we seize it? How do we get from here to there? How do we realize the vision? Where do we go? In very hard, practical terms. A lot of inspiring talk, that's really important. Inspiration is important. Words do matter. But actions matter too. And so the question is, how we have to agree with it. That's a purposeful panic. We have a wonderful panic. I'm not going to spend a lot of time on this thing you have in your seats there. You should have a lot of these. You know, Michelle done and what she's done with Amazon, but I don't know, built it up to a national organization and now it's got points of light in with it. Who has to introduce an usher? Listen, I was here when he played for the NFL kickoff last week. I still can't hear. But I saw what magic he had with the young people. General Franklin, who is in charge of recruitment and training of all new enlistees and officers in the United States Army. And maybe that's a large task. Vanessa Kirsch, who has formed organizations that most of us can do with Lifetime, the Profit, and now America Forward. There's a lot of responsibility for a big and then finally, Mallory, who is, and your last name, Mallory, I should put this down again, because if you are, she is, as Mallory has been AmeriCorps, she has done Jumpstart, and she has done, and she has done, City, you've done both. Where's your red jacket? You got the red jacket. You've done all this in the world.
Absolutely.
Now tell me, because I'm gonna mangle your last name, so I want to make sure you pronounce it correctly.
I can say Hassel since I'm speaking to myself today.
Yeah,
Jocelyn,
you see me. Okay, Jocelyn. Okay. Mallory Jocelyn, thank you. Okay, let's open up with Vanessa. Vanessa, where do we go from here? How do we build, how do we seize upon this moment? Did we just turn it over to Alan Casey?
Yeah.
Or is there something more that we should be doing? You perhaps have had some pillow talk about that subject. But frame this for us. Yeah, where do we go from here?
The thing is, we all did history over that. Doing anything means just leave my friend with me. I'm going to actually start talking personally because I think, you know, our story and what's happened is, does speak to how this movement is evolving. You know, I just am thinking and pinching myself. Just being here today with all of you, so many of us, if we all have been in this for it's a long journey. But, you know, my journey started when I was 25 years old and I was running Public Allies and I heard about this great organization in Boston called City Year. And this guy, Harris Walker, said, you gotta go out to Boston and meet your competition. And so for me, National Service has been, it's an idea, it's a concept, but it's part of our lives, and I was lucky to meet my wonderful husband, Alan, and we've been on a journey, and when I think of the fact that at 25 years old, you know, I was sitting with people like Eli Siegel, who is so here in spirit, and, you know, all of us. I just keep thinking of Eli, and I know he's grinning, because, you know, finally are getting incredible bipartisan support. And everything that Eli talked about making service the fabric of our country, is really coming true. But to be a young person, experiencing sitting with, you know, people like that, and actually inventing and creating something that is today AmeriCorps, was an incredible privilege. And then to be sitting here today, thinking about what happened last night with Obama and McCain, talking about these issues and realizing we have the opportunity to do something truly amazing to the entirely next level, taking this level. It's just, I don't know, it's just hard. I'm speechless. I can barely sort of think every minute because it's just so incredible what is happening here. And I guess I do, even before I go into, I do want to get into the tactics because we can be inspiring and be great, but we really have to work to do. I think that there are, that what I heard last night was a talking about a new role for government. And I'm not sure that even the candidates are quite yet articulating what that new role is. And I want to highlight how AmeriCorps, in essence, has been a new role for government. AmeriCorps is not just a government program, as some had talked about it. AmeriCorps has been a way of government investing in what works, investing in the nonprofit sector, investing in organizations like Youth Build, Teach America.